Very good morning, my dear children. Welcome back in your online arithmetic class. Girls, today we are going to revise some topics from the chapter numbers. So let's start our revision class. Let us start with ordering of numbers. What is ordering of numbers? Ordering numbers mean arrangement of numbers either from small to big or from big to small. For that, we have to compare the numbers first. So girls, it is nothing but ascending and descending order. But before arranging the number, we have to compare them, right? So how can we compare the numbers? When comparing numbers, always start by comparing the digits at the highest place value. You can see here we have taken the example of 1952 and 1592. So if we are going to compare this number, first of all we need to compare the digits at the highest place value. So you can see that here I have placed these two numbers in the place value chart, and from the chart I can see that the both numbers starts with 1000. That means the highest place value are same for these two numbers. Now if the digits are equal, move one place value to the right and compare again. So now as we can see that 1000 are same for both numbers, so we are moving to the one place value to the right. So we have hundreds place, and here we can see that for first number we have 900s and for the second number we have 500s. And we know 9 is greater than 5. So obviously we can say that 1952 is greater than 1592. Clear? So girls, for comparing two numbers, first of all we need to compare the digits at the highest place value. That is 1000 here in this example. And if these digits are equal, then move one place value to the right. That is hundreds here, right? And then compare it again. All right, please remember this rule. Now let us try out some examples. Number one, insert the correct signs. 1, 1000 plus 7. The second number is 1007. And the third number is 1000 plus 10 plus 7. Here, first of all, we are going to consider first two numbers. These are 1000 plus 7. That's mean 1007 and the second number 1007. So these two numbers are equal. We are going to put equal sign the box given between first and second number. Done. Now we will consider second and third number. The second number is 1007 and the third number is 1000 plus 10 plus 7. That's mean 1017. Now girls, we know 1007 is lesser than 1017. So we are going to put lesser than marks in between second and third number gap. Okay, clear? Now question number 2. 5 tens plus 8 ones. That's mean 58. And here we have 7 into 8 means 56. So you can easily understand which is the bigger number. So we are going to put a greater than sign over here. Okay. Number 2. Circle the greatest number. So look at the numbers very carefully and then find out which one is the biggest number. And please do follow the rules of comparing two numbers. Okay. Number 3. Tick the smallest number. So here the smallest number is 556. Okay. Let's try out this sum on your own. Okay. Number 1. Fill in the correct symbol. A. 1305-1250. B. 1000 plus 50 plus 5-1200 plus 50 plus 5-1200 plus 55. Number C, 1000 minus 5-260 plus 700. D, 15 into 10-25 into 4-60 into 6. Number E, 144 plus 16-15 into 8. So girls, here you have to calculate the thing first. Means if it is adding up the numbers, then you have to add it and then you have to compare the numbers. Okay, so first do the calculation and then compare the numbers. Number 2. Tick the greatest number. A. Number 1,309, 1,369, 1,596, 1,596, B, 629, 922, 690. Number 3, circle the smallest number. A, 553, 545, 554, B, 1025, 1052, 1009, 1011. Now Let us quickly recollect ascending order and descending order. Girls, always remember, when we arrange the numbers in an increasing order, that's mean smallest to biggest. So please remember, increasing order means smallest to biggest, and it is known as ascending order. Sometimes we get confused about that, right? So please remember, increasing means smallest to biggest, and that is known as ascending order. Okay, now let's try these two examples. Number one, the answer will be 1002. This is the smallest one. Then comes 1003, right? Then 1030, and the last number means the biggest one is 1300. All right. Likewise, the second answer is 284. That is the smallest one. Then comes 824. Then 849. And the last one is 892. Okay, done. Now, when the numbers are arranged in a decreasing order, that's mean biggest to smallest, just the reverse, then they are known as descending order. So descending order means biggest to smallest. Let's try out these examples. Number one, 549, 494, and 495. So here we are going to follow the rules of comparing numbers, right? So we are going to start from the highest place value, okay, and then move to right. Okay, and if you do the same, then the answer will be, the biggest number here is 594, then comes 549, right? Then 495, and the last means the smallest number is 459. Likewise, the answer of example 2 is 1010, biggest number, then 1000, then 792, and the smallest one is 729. Okay. Now, girls, please try out the following problems at home. There are two type of sums over here. Rewrite in ascending order and rewrite in descending order. All right. Let us discuss about forming greatest and smallest numbers. Girls, we can make numbers from the given digits. Now let's see the rules. Rule 1. To get the smallest number, arrange the digits in ascending order from left to right. And girls, ascending order means correct. It means smallest to biggest. Example, Write the smallest number using the digits 5, 2, 3 and 1. So as per rules, we are going to arrange the digits in ascending order, that means smallest to biggest, from left to right. So first the smallest number, that will be 1, right? Then comes 2, then 3, then 5. So our answer is the smallest number is 1235. Done. Now rule 2. To get the greatest number, arrange the digits in descending order from left to right. So descending order means girls? Correct. It means biggest to smallest. Example, write the greatest number using the digits 7, 8, 6 and 4. So girls, here we are going to arrange these digits in descending order. That's mean biggest to smallest, right? So our answer will be the greatest number is, the biggest digit is 8, so it's come first, then 7, then 6, then 4. That's mean 8764. Okay. Now let us learn rule 3. It is very important, girls, please pay attention. If 0 is one of the digits while forming the smaller number, it is written in the place after the highest place. Highest place means if it is a 4-digit number, then the highest place is 1000, because the place value of 1000 is 1000, that is the highest among the other place values, right? So what we have to do, if we have a digit as 0, then while we are forming the smaller number, we cannot start it with 0. But we will put 0 in the place after the highest place. So we cannot write 0 in 1000 place. Clear? So if we are going to use the digits 7, 2, 3 and 0, and we have to find out the smallest number, then the number is 2037. So girls, you can see that here we put 0 in the place after the highest place. Means in 1000 place, we have put 2. Means the second number. The smallest number is 0. After that comes 2. So we are putting 2 in 1000 place and putting 0 in the place after the highest place, that is in hundreds place, right? So here the smallest number is 2037. Clear? Now girls, one more thing. If we put 0 in 1000 place, then the answer will be wrong. Why so? Because here we are going to form a 4-digit number, right? 0 means nothing. If 0 comes first, then the number will be 237. That is a 3-digit number. So then our answer will be wrong. So please remember, whenever you get 0, you have to put the 0 in the place after the highest place. Clear? So girls, think and answer the following questions on your own. Number 1. The smallest 4-digit number is dash. Number 2. Write the largest 4-digit number with digits 1, 0, 7, 9. Number 3. The largest 3-digit number is dash. Number 4. Write the greatest and smallest 4-digit numbers with the digits 6, 0, 9 and 0. Number 5. Make our greatest and smallest 4-digit numbers using the following digits. So girls, here digits are given. So you have to arrange them and make a greatest and smallest number. Clear? Now, let us discuss the last topic for the day. Place value and expand. So here we are going to solve some problems. You have to do it on your own. The only thing, I can give you some hints. Okay? So let's start with question number 1. 17 tens plus 9 wands equal to what? Girls, I hope you know that 17 tens means 17 into 10. That gives us 170. Okay? So please do the sum on your own. Number 2. The sum of 585 and 215 is dash hundreds. So what you have to do? You have to add these two numbers and then you have to find out how many hundreds are there in the answer. Got it? Number 3. 10 sets of 9 plus 10 equal to how many tens? So girls, here the hint is 10 tens equal to 100. Okay? And I hope you know that 10 sets of 9 means 10 into 9. Okay? Question number 4. 5 into 8 plus 9 into 5 equal to dash tens plus dash ones. So you have to multiply and then add these two products, then you have to expand the answer. Okay? Number 5. 89 plus 9 equal to 9 tens plus dash ones. Number 6. In 1548, the digit 4 stands for? So girls, here 4 stands for what? Do you remember the place value? Yes, place value chart. I hope you recall that, right? Okay, so 4 is in tens place. So you have to write the answer. Number 7. In 8936, the place value of 8 is the same thing. So you have to find out the place value. Okay. Number 8, expand 8165. Fine. So girls, that's all for today. Please practice all the sums at home. Okay? So stay safe, be healthy. God bless you.